The 1980s was one of the most historical and iconic decades out there that we should appreciate and learn more about. In this video, you will learn about everything from Ronald Reagan to the Valley Girls. The 80s were all about style, drugs, and excess. It was the decade of decadence. Now we will go through the struggles, trends, and the excitement of this complex decade. In 1980, the turn of the new decade, we were forgetting bell-bottom jeans for blazers with shoulder pads, peace signs for hairspray, and disco dyed for new wave pop music. The dawn of the decade, 1980, the year started off in a dreary recession while people were still feeling the effects of the oil crisis from the 70s. Many were jobless and prices were high. As people eagerly watched the news for reports on better economy, a new crisis began. On May 18, 1980, an earthquake occurred, causing Mount St. Helens to erupt in Washington, spewing forth its ash, which traveled into 11 other states. The eruption was preceded with 2 months full of earthquakes and steam venting episodes. 57 souls were taken that day, and $2.88 billion worth of damage was made. It was the biggest eruption to take place in 48 states since 1915. If Mount St. Helens wasn't enough for this year to handle, American hostages were still being held in Iran. November 4, 1979, 52 American diplomats and citizens were held hostage to Iranian college students. As 1980 rolled by, they were still being held in captivity. This was also the year Ronald Reagan was elected president in a Republican sweep on November 4, 1980. On January 20, 1981, 2 minutes after Reagan was sworn in, Iran released all of its hostages they held for 444 days out of fear of Reagan possibly taking fierce action. Another shocking day for America came by too soon on December 8, 1980, as John Lennon, a member from the Beatles, was making his way back home with his wife Yoko Ono, a mentally unstable 25-year-old security guard by the name of Mark David Chapman, shot Lennon in New York City. Many were shocked and upset by the death of Lennon, and music was never the same. As the year passed on by, Ted Turner launched the first all-news network on June 1, 1980, called CNN. May 22nd, Pac-Man was released, causing Pac-Man fever to spread, while the Rubik's Cube rose to fame. A few popular movies rising to the top of the charts consisted of The Shining, Friday the 13th, and The Empire Strikes Back. Top songs included Blondie's hit Call Me and Michael Jackson's Rock With You. As 1980 transitioned into 1981, Americans were just getting used to the new decade. Reagan's presidency was favored by many, but 3 months into the new leader's first term, one man made history with an evil scheme on his mind. March 30, 1981, 69 days into Reagan's presidency, Reagan was speaking at the Washington Hilton Hotel and was shot in an assassination attempt by John Hinckley Jr. Reagan was hit in the chest and lower right arm. He suffered a puncture wound to the lung an inch away from his heart and internal bleeding. John Hinckley Jr.'s case was one of the first where a defendant used insanity as a defense to plea not guilty.
He was so white. I had never seen anybody so white. And he had that thing over his face to help him breathe. There was blood. And he opened his eyes and saw me, and that's when he said, "Honey, I forgot to duck."
After the spread of STDs in the disco era, a new unusual disease popped up. April 24th, 1980, the first AIDS case was brought to attention. June 5th, 1981, the CDC released an article explaining 5 gay men with an unusual infection of failing immune systems after acquiring pneumonia. Sadly, the immune systems failed completely, and January 15, 1981 was the first death caused by AIDS. By the end of 1981, 121 people died that are known of. Rock Hudson, age 61, was among these deaths soon after, which brought the public eye more drawn in with AIDS. While music is changing into new wave pop, an innovative idea from Tom Freston and Robert Pittman brought one of the most iconic channels in U.S. history, MTV. MTV went on the air August 1, 1981, playing around-the-clock music videos 24 hours a day, debuting with Video Killed the Radio Star. The channel became an instant hit and played thousands of music videos throughout the years, helping many artists rise to fame. Other historical events include the assassination attempt on the Pope, May 13th, and the release of IBM's personal computer with a running Microsoft disk operating system. Popular movies were Raiders of the Lost Ark, Escape from New York, and The Road Warrior. Hit songs were Rick Springfield's Jesse's Girl and Kim Carnes' Betty Davis Eyes.
In 1982, the long dark war of Vietnam was finally being honored. The Vietnam War Memorial opened in Washington, D.C., November 10th. The memorial includes inscribed black granite walls filled with the names of more than 58,000 men and women who gave their lives and or remain missing. The memorial itself is dedicated to honor the courage, sacrifice, and devotion to duty and country of all who served in the longest U.S. war in history. 3 acres in the northwest corner of the National Mall was set aside for the memorial. It was dedicated on November 13, 1982. 1982 also came with a great turn for medical technology. Robert Jarvik and a team of seven designed and implemented a permanent artificial heart in a man by the name of Dr. Barney B. Clark, age 61, at the University of Utah Medical Center in Salt Lake City on December 2, 1982, to support a failing heart. Popular movies at this time were E.T., Poltergeist, and Blade Runner. Top songs included Survivor's Eye of the Tiger and Joan Jett and the Blackhearts' I Love Rock and Roll. '83 was a great leap for women. Sally K. Ride, age 32, became the first woman astronaut in space as a crew member aboard Space Shuttle Challenger on June 18th. Ride joined NASA in 1978 and left NASA after flying twice on the Space Shuttle Challenger in 1987. Ride was one of the 8,000 people who answered an advertisement in the Stanford student newspaper seeking applicants for the space program. Ride had received many awards, including the National Space Society's Von Braun Award, the Lindbergh Eagle, and the NCAA's Theodore Roosevelt Award. While the year progressed, so did drugs. The Bahamas were creating a deadly future for the life of many Americans, creating what we know as crack. Soon after creation, crack, aka cocaine, was spreading like wildfire throughout the United States.
Is there anyone out there who still isn't clear about what doing drugs does? Okay, last time. This is your brain. This is drugs. This is your brain on drugs. Any questions?
October 23, 1983 was filled with terror and grief as 237 U.S. Marines were killed in Beirut, Lebanon due to a terrorist explosion. This occurred during the Lebanese Civil War as 2 truck bombs hit separate buildings housing the United States and the French military force, killing altogether 299 American and French servicemen. Islamic Jihad was responsible for these bombings. Important historical moments included the introduction of noise-free compact discs, Cabbage Patch Kids becoming very popular, 125 million viewers tuning into the last episode of MASH, and the FCC authorizing Motorola to begin testing cellular phone service in Chicago. Popular movies were The Right Stuff, Return of the Jedi, Scarface, and a favorite of many, A Christmas Story. Music at the top of the charts included two hits from Michael Jackson's Billie Jean and Beat It, Police with Every Breath You Take, and Men at Work, Down Under.
Technology took another great step as Apple introduced the user-friendly Macintosh personal computer on January 24, 1984. The project began in 1979 with Steve Jobs and Jeff Raskin. The computer was named after Jeff Raskin's favorite type of Apple, the Macintosh. The name was changed for legal reasons and had to be respelled. The screen was 12 inches. December 3, 1984, yet another tragic event takes place in the world. A toxic gas leak from Union Carbide plant in Bhopal, India, killed 2,000 people and injured 150,000. Over 500,000 people were exposed to the methyl isocyanate gas and other chemicals, and by the end of 2 weeks, 8,000 people had died and 8,000 more have died since. It is considered to be the world's worst industrial disaster ever. Other historical events include President Reagan being re-elected in landslide with 59% of votes, The Cosby Show making its debut on NBC, the band Band-Aid releasing Do They Know It's Christmas, with proceeds going to starving people in Africa, and the Supreme Court ruling that taping television shows at home on VCRs do not violate copyright law. The great films that released this year were The Karate Kid, Ghostbusters, A Nightmare on Elm Street, and Red Dawn. Miami Vice, a popular television show at that time, also made its debut this year. Top songs included Tina Turner's What's Love Got to Do with It and Kenny Loggins' Footloose.
When 1985 began, a gaping hole was discovered. The ozone layer had reported to have a hole in it. While a group of scientists were monitoring the stratosphere over Antarctica, they came across the ozone layer opening. The hole began to grow in August and reached its largest area in depth in the middle of September to early October. Colder conditions resulted in a larger area and lower ozone values in the center of the hole. With a new discovery comes closure to an old mystery. After the sinking of the Titanic in 1912, nobody had a clue to where the wreckage had went. On the early morning of September 1st, 1985, one of the Titanic's massive boilers had been found. American Robert T. Ballard headed an expedition with an experimental and unmanned submersible developed by the U.S. Navy to search for the ocean liner. The liner was sunken to about 13,000 feet in depth and was 400 miles east of Newfoundland in the North Atlantic. On a more funnier note, Coca-Cola decided to come out with a new formula and to change the one they had previously had for almost a century. There is speculation that the new Coke formula introduction was just a marketing ploy, but the company has always claimed it was merely an attempt to replace the original product. The America's reaction was quite negative. Although promoted by Bill Cosby, it just wasn't enough. Even though a lot of failure came out of this, when Coca-Cola changed their product back to the original, Coca-Cola was more popular than ever due to the comeback.
What's the matter, Wilbur?
They changed my Coke.
Something wrong with it?
I know, they sure changed it.
Coulda asked.
What coulda? I stuck with them through three wars and a couple of dust storms, but this is too much. Guess something big made them change.
Right, big.
Right, big. Pepsi, the choice of a new generation.
Still could have asked.
Popular movies of this year included The Goonies, The Breakfast Club, and Back to the Future. Top charted songs were Madonna's Like a Virgin and Foreigner's I Want to Know What Love Is.
Seconds in counting, the 51L mission ready to go. In Los Angeles, where it is 3 hours earlier than Florida, NBC's affiliate, KNBC, decided to cover the launch live.
This is a special report coming from Channel 4 News. Good morning, I'm Ken Shocknick, and Space Shuttle Challenger is just a few seconds away from blasting off from the Kennedy Space Center near Cape Canaveral, Florida. Let's take a look right now. Challenger finally getting ready to leave KSC. It's launch delayed a couple of times because of weather and mechanical problems.
T-minus 15 seconds.
The voice of launch control, Hugh Harris of NASA.
T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. We have main engine start, 4, 3, 2, 1, and liftoff.
1986 came with great success and tragic failure. The year started off with anything but a happy new year. January 28th, seven crew members stepped aboard the Space Shuttle Challenger, one of them being Krista McAuliffe, a teacher who joined for the Teacher in Space project. The Teacher in Space project had been announced by Ronald Reagan in 1984 to inspire students and teachers to do more in the classroom and to get more attention toward NASA's space program. At 11:38 a.m., 73 seconds into the Challenger's flight, the spacecraft disintegrated over the Atlantic Ocean off the coast of Cape Canaveral, Florida, being watched live by 17% of Americans. All seven crew members were killed in this explosion.
APUs, the auxiliary power units.
2,257 feet per second. Altitude 4.3 nautical miles. Downrange distance 3 nautical miles.
It's always amazing to hear how quickly the shuttle moves. It's already more than 4 miles downwind as we just heard.
Engine throttling up. 3 engines now at 104%.
Challenger, go at throttle up.
Challenger, go at throttle up.
This shuttle mission will launch. My God.
1 minute 15.
There's been an explosion.
Velocity 2,900 feet per second. Altitude 9 nautical miles. Downrange distance 7 nautical miles.
This is not standard. This is not something that is planned, of course. I can see a solid rocket booster has broken away from Shuttle Challenger. That's what you're looking at in the middle of your screen. I cannot see the shuttle itself. I don't know if it's able to continue on one rocket booster. If it's able to jettison that rocket booster, it will be able to return to the Kennedy Space Center. Perhaps the shuttle engines are not enough to power the shuttle back down.
Flight
it would have
controllers
to shut down.
Are looking very carefully at the situation. Obviously a major malfunction.
I hope they were able to survive. I hope the
astronauts... We have no downlink.
We have absolutely no sign at all of the shuttle itself. All we saw was that one explosion, only about a minute into the flight, and we saw the solid rocket booster. Now here's something coming down. I don't know what that is. I don't think that that's the shuttle. I believe that's a piece of debris that's coming back earthbound. I don't know. It's too small for the shuttle itself. Pieces falling out of the sky in the Florida morning. It's about 20 till noon in Florida. There are contingency plans for the shuttle when something does go wrong, when something goes terribly wrong.
We have a report from the flight dynamics officer that the vehicle has exploded. Flight director confirms that. We are looking at checking with the recovery forces to see what can be done at this point.
8:40, and we hear from launch control the vehicle has exploded. That's the orbiter itself. The Shuttle Challenger has exploded.
Contingency procedures are in effect.
Assume that the crew is not alive.
With disaster over with, another one begins. April 26, 1986, 1:23 a.m., Reactor 4 at the nuclear power plant near Chernobyl, Ukraine exploded. The explosion released more than 100 times the radiation of the bombs dropped on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Shortly after this explosion, 31 people died. Many more have died and or are expected to due to the effects the radiation has had on them. The Chernobyl disaster is the worst nuclear power plant accident in history by cost and deaths. It is one of the only two classified as a Level 7 event, the other being the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear disaster in 2011. Within the year, a new game that had been introduced to the United States a year previously was spreading like wildfire in popularity. The game, initially being released in Japan in 1983, had finally made its way to the US, being the best-selling game console of its time. These games were named Nintendo games. Other big events of this time included Barry Diller, head of News Corp, creating Fox, the fourth television network offering 10 hours of primetime programming a week, Halley's Comet making a visit, and Dick Rutan and Gina Yeager making the first non-stop flight around the world without refueling. The Voyager flew around the world, 24,986 miles from Edwards AFB, California, returning in 216 hours, 3 minutes, and 44 seconds from December 14th to December 23rd. Top movies at the time were Platoon, Top Gun, Stand By Me, Ferris Bueller's Day Off, and Pretty in Pink. A popular song at the top of the charts that was stuck in many people's heads was Mr. Mister's Broken Wings.
Today I say, as long as this gate is closed, as long as this scar of a wall is permitted to stand, it is not the German question alone that remains open, but the question of freedom for all mankind. In the 1950s, Khrushchev predicted, "We will bury you." But in the West today, we see a free world that has achieved a level of prosperity and well-being unprecedented in all human history. In the communist world, we see failure. There is one sign the Soviets can make that would be unmistakable, that would advance dramatically the cause of freedom and peace. General Secretary Gorbachev, if you seek peace, if you seek prosperity for the Soviet Union and Eastern Europe, if you seek liberalization, come here to this gate. Mr. Gorbachev, open this gate.
Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall.
1987 was a big year for the news industry. June 12, 1987, President Ronald Reagan traveled to Berlin and made one of the most famous Cold War speeches in history. This speech challenged Soviet leader Mikhail Gorbachev to tear down the Berlin Wall. Many were mesmerized by the speech and became greatly inspired. The next big event that took place this year was one of the greatest for news coverage. October 14th, an 18-month-year-old baby by the name of Jessica fell down a well in the backyard of Tanner Drive, Midland, Texas. Baby Jessica was occupying an 18-inch-wide and 22-feet-deep space. Rescuers worked for 58 hours around the clock with new ideas trying to free Jessica McClure as millions around the world prayed. News media gave worldwide attention to baby Jessica, also covering the rescue as baby Jessica was finally freed. 5 days after news media gained great attention due to baby Jessica, on October 19, 1987, news media gained even more viewers when stock markets around the world crashed, being called Black Monday. The crash began in Hong Kong and spread west to Europe, hitting the United States soon after. Wall Street Black Monday affected millions in finance. One last event of the year that has made a great impact on the world today. DNA was first used to convict criminals. Top movies were Wall Street, The Lost Boys, Dirty Dancing, Predator, and RoboCop. Popular songs included Bangles' Walk Like an Egyptian and Heart's Alone. 1988 came off as a disastrous year. January 2nd, Ashland Oil storage tanks spilled 3.8 million gallons of diesel oil into the Monongahela River. The spill grew 33 miles long and was the second largest oil spill in history of western Pennsylvania and one of the worst inland oil spills in the nation. While America was still dealing with the Ashland oil spill, on July 3rd, U.S. Navy ships shot down an Iranian airliner in the Persian Gulf, mistaking it for a jet fighter. 290 people were killed. As the year approached to an ending, December 22nd, a Pan Am 747 exploded from a terrorist bomb and crashed into Lockerbie, Scotland, killing all 259 aboard and 11 on the ground. Top movies of the time were Rain Man, Mississippi Burning, Beetlejuice, and Die Hard. Popular music was George Michael's Faith, INXS's Need You Tonight, Rick Astley's Never Gonna Give You Up, and Guns N' Roses' Sweet Child of Mine. While popular music thrived as new songs came and went, CDs started to outsell vinyl records for the first time in history. '89, the last decade of the 80s, came with grief and joy. October 17th, San Francisco Bay Area, California, was hit with a terrorizing earthquake, lasting 15 seconds and a moment of magnitude of 6.9. It caused 60 deaths, thousands of injuries, and great damage. It was the strongest earthquake to hit the area since the San Francisco earthquake of 1906. Even though disaster hit, joy was arriving. On November 9th, after 28 years, the Berlin Wall was torn down and opened to West Berlin. The destruction of the wall marked the symbolic end of war and allowed travel. Millions around the world also celebrated as the celebration was broadcasted throughout the night. Families who hadn't seen each other in almost 30 years reunited. The celebration seemed to last a lifetime.
City of Berlin, east and west, was out in the streets. A street party that hasn't stopped for 36 hours. The euphoria is catching, dancing down the main streets, east and west Berliners who can't get enough of their new unity.
Just in time for the end of the 80s, the first World Wide Web server and browser was developed by Tim Berners-Lee and was introduced, making it possible for everybody to access a web page via the internet. Top movies to end the decade included Born on the 4th of July, Field of Dreams, Say Anything, and Batman. Popular music included Poison's Every Rose Has Its Thorn, Chicago's Look Away, Paula Abdul's Straight Up, and Janet Jackson's Miss You Much.
Today.